Okay, basically, the acid base property of oxide is related to their bonding and structure. Okay, we can see here that carbon monoxide and silicon monoxide both are covalent compound which have covalent bond. Okay, while the germanium monoxide, tin monoxide and lead monoxide, okay, are ionic compound which have ionic bond. Okay, but this amphoteric nature, okay, has covalent character. Alright, why it have covalent character? Because of the higher charge and smaller size. Alright, okay, and then when we take a look for the dioxide, okay, carbon dioxide and silicon dioxide both also, okay, are covalent compound with covalent bond. Okay, and okay, the germanium dioxide, tin dioxide and lead dioxide, okay, for those ionic compound with ionic bond and also has covalent character. Okay, so we can see that this all because of the size, because of the smaller size of carbon monoxide, silicon monoxide. So it form covalent compound which covalent bond. So its structure, okay, its structure is simple covalent molecule. Okay, because of the smaller size of both compound, so both compound have a simple covalent molecule which is both, okay, are gaseous state. Okay, while for structure of amphoteric compound, okay, they have intermediate between giant ionic and covalent structure because it have both. Okay, it have both character. It have ionic compound but it has covalent character. Okay, but we can see that the amphoteric nature of germanium oxide is greater, okay, followed by tin monoxide and lead monoxide. And we can see that the ionic properties of group 14 oxide compound is become increasing, okay, down the group. Okay, so ionic properties of group 14 oxide become increasing down the group. Alright, so because of the size. Alright, and then, okay, we take a look for the dioxide form. Okay, so for structure of carbon dioxide, okay, this carbon dioxide is simple covalent molecule. Okay, which is, it is a, okay, gas state. Okay, while for German silicon, okay, silicon dioxide, it is covalent compound, but because of its large structure, okay, it have giant covalent structure with higher melting point. Okay, and then for amphoteric nature of germanium dioxide, anti-lead dioxide, okay, these three have intermediate between giant ionic and covalent structure. Okay, so because of the higher melting and boiling point, so this four compound is a solid state. Okay, same goes to the monoxide of amphoteric nature compound. So it is a solid compound. Okay, let we see the structure of carbon monoxide. Okay, for carbon monoxide, we know that it have triple bond. Okay, and it is a small size, very smaller size, small size, okay, compared to other oxides. Okay, and then, okay, because it very smaller size and the structure is simple covalent molecule, so it have weak van der Waal forces between, okay, molecule. Okay, so make it gas phase lah. Alright, for same goes to, okay, for silicon monoxide, okay, it also have a small size, but it's larger size compared to carbon monoxide. Okay, so it still have a weak van der Waal forces. Alright, so that's why carbon monoxide and silicon monoxide both are gases because both have a weak van der Waal forces. And then we take a look for the carbon dioxide. Okay, for carbon dioxide, as you know that carbon dioxide have a two double bond, which is the smaller size compared to the other dioxide compound. Alright, so it also have weak van der Waal forces. Weak van der Waal, okay, forces between molecules. So that's why it is a gas state. Alright, okay, but okay, for silicon dioxide, it have giant covalent structure. And okay, I know that before we already draw the structure. Okay, let's draw again the structure of silicon dioxide. Alright, so okay, the first one is you must draw it okay in tetrahedral shape. Okay, tetrahedral shape. Okay, and then tetrahedral shape. Okay, draw again. Okay, and then draw. Okay. Okay, and then. Okay. Right, and then. Okay, it's bonded. Okay, by silicon atom. Okay, the darker one, the smaller one is a silicon. Silicon. Okay, so this is Si atom. Okay, and then why between Si it have O. Okay, it have oxygen atom. So this is oxygen atom. Alright, this is how you draw the silicon dioxide structure. Okay, which is it have a giant covalent structure. Okay, hence okay, for silicon dioxide, it's only consists of covalent bond. It's only have covalent bond. So that's why the silicon dioxide is a solid because it have no weak van der Waal forces, which is have higher melting point. Have some information that you must know about carbon. Okay, carbon is a smallest size. Okay, of group 14. Okay, the smallest size of a group 14. Okay, so it can form strongest carbon bond. Okay, as well as strong as. Okay, as strong as carbon oxide bond. Okay. Hence, because of that, okay, carbon has okay ability to catenate. Okay, to catenate. Okay, to form okay stable long chain okay and ring compound. Okay, what is long chain? Okay the example. Okay this long chain, okay, also known as organic compound that okay you really familiar lah. Example, we have propane here. Okay, so this is the longest chain. Okay, we have pentane here. Okay, pentane here. Okay, why on the carbon can form this longest chain? Okay, either straight chain or branch chain. Okay, why? Because of its ability to catenate to form a stable long chain and ring compound. Okay, what is catenation? Okay, catenation. Okay, catenation is ability to form okay, to form bond, okay, between, okay, two or more atom, okay, using covalent bond. Okay, so because of the smallest size of carbon, okay, so this carbon can can catenate, okay, itself, okay, carbon and another carbon to form longest chain. Alright, so that's why we can say that carbon is the most element, okay, is the most element, okay, the most common element, okay, sorry, the most common element, okay, that exhibit, okay, catenation, okay, catenation. How about silicon? Okay, actually silicon is also one of the element which can catenate. Okay, catenate, okay, like carbon. But okay, since SiO bond, okay, SiO bond is stronger, okay, compared to Si bond, okay, so that's why as silicon only can catenate, okay, by using O to form SiO bond. Okay, so that's why what we can see for silicon, okay, it must catenate to form a large compound, okay, with oxygen. Okay, so we can see like this lah. So it can form large compound of SiO. Alright. Okay. So. Okay. So that's why form this large compound. Okay. Finally, because of its bonded with SiO4. Okay. SiO. Okay. So we can see that it will form tetrahedrally shape. Okay, which hexagon shape. Okay, so to form a giant covalent compound. Alright, like this. Okay, like we draw earlier. Alright. Okay, so that's why for SiO2. Okay, for SiO2. Okay, so for SiO2. SiO2. Okay, SiO, so that's why for SiO2, okay, it will form giant, okay, covalent structure. Alright, so this is about catenation. And okay, or we can take one part, so we can draw it as, alright, Si, okay, O, and until we make it as a large structure of SiO2. We have done learn about oxide of group 14.